Greater Reading Public Eye on BCTV is supported by RCJ Consulting.
Hi, thank you so much for joining me today on Greater Reading Public Eye on BCTV. It's really good to see everybody. I hope you've been having a great and safe holiday. I shouldn't say holiday. I guess it is for some people going back to school, summer, vacation and season. I hope you'll stay tuned. I'm going to introduce you to our guest on today's show. And I just want to remind you that Greater Reading Public Eye is about featuring somebody in our community that's doing something great, good for the rest of us. And sometimes we see them out there and sometimes they're behind the scenes. So I'm going to introduce you to somebody who's behind the scenes and in front of the scenes. And with me today is Dr. Jennifer Murray with the Reading School District.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Dr. Murray is the recently new superintendent of the Reading School District, so you may have seen her out and about. She's been meeting with a lot of people in groups and keeping things moving with the administration at the school building. And since we are getting to the end of summer, I thought this was a great opportunity to sit down and talk with her. So again, I hope you'll stay tuned and find out what's going on at the Reading School District. Mm-hmm. So with that said, first we're going to start with you, Dr. Murray, and ask you to talk a little bit about yourself, where you're from, what's kept you here in the Reading area, what your history has been with the school district.
Sure. So I actually was originally from Bucks County. So don't hold that against me. And I moved into the Berks County area in the early 90s. Mm-hmm. My husband was employed by the Reading Police Department, and we had moved into the area, and I had started subbing in the Reading School District. So since then, I have three kids.
I was going to say, did you have children yet?
I did.
This was pre,
Yes, this was before kids.
Oh,
we moved up
pre
here,
kids.
Started working.
Okay.
I had three wonderful kids. They're old now. They're 19.
But you're not.
No. They're 19, 23, and 24.
Wow.
So I have one left in the house, and I have been with the Reading School District ever since. So,
what are some of the positions that you've held? You really came up through the ranks.
I did.
You know the district.
I did. So back in the 90s, when we moved here, I actually started as a substitute teacher at 16th and Hawk. And I subbed actually in music class. I'm not a music person, but I did. You are now. I am now. then I got a job after subbing for probably 6 months at 16th and Hawk.
That's a great place to start.
Yeah.
So I didn't even know that.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. And I was hired because, you know, I was there all the time anyway, and I guess I did a good job. But Mrs. Wilson hired me as a fourth grade teacher. And I worked there for a couple of years as a fourth grade teacher. The principal had moved me to second grade, and because of low enrollment, my classroom closed.
Oh.
And since I was least senior, I was actually moved to 13th and Union as a teacher.
Mm.
And I met a lot of great people there, too. After teaching about 4 years, I became a reading coach. I went back to 16th and Hawk. I love that job, working with teachers and supporting staff and professional development. I then became an assistant principal at Northwest Area Elementary School. I worked with Laura Nelson Turner for a number of years. focusing again on instructional practices and professional development. Mm-hmm. And then in 2006, I was lucky enough to be named the principal of one of the new gateway schools that we opened up.
Yes.
And it was over at Glenside. It mm-hmm. was the Performing Arts Gateway School. Mm-hmm. It was a great school. So at that time, we were focused on smarter, safer, smaller schools. So it was a breakdown of the sixth grade magnet school. And I was the principal there for a number of years. We actually moved that building because of the facilities over to the City Line Avenue Street, which was the former Jewish Community Center. Mm-hmm. And because of the stage and the facilities was better towards performing arts. So we moved there, and I was there for a year, then came to district office as the director of literacy. And then in 2010, the district faced a lot of a financial crisis and budget cuts,
yes.
and we had closed the magnet schools.
Yeah, that was a tough time.
It was. Then. It was. A lot of furloughed positions, and we actually had closed Thomas Ford Elementary, too.
Right.
So I was then named the principal at Millmont, and I had to merge Thomas Ford Elementary. It was a beautiful community, a beautiful school.
You dealt with a lot of heartbreak, anger, emotions, because people really did love that school.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. It was. It was, you know, named after a former superintendent. There was a lot of tradition, history, very tight-knit community in Oak Brook. And so they then had to be transported over to Millmont Elementary, which again was a very tight-knit community around their Millmont, very small. They had one of each grade level, and they went through some major changes, you know, having that merger happen to them too. And it was hard. It was hard on a lot of families and the community, but it's something that the district had to do. And I think looking back at Millmont now, having those two communities together is a great school.
Yeah,
it's
it
a great
is.
Atmosphere over there with Dr. Rostek as the principal. So I was
great.
Over there for a number of years. And then in 2015,
I think that's when I first met you.
Probably.
You were principal at Millmont.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then 2015, Dr. Mameen had talked me into taking a position.
I remember that, yes.
As the assistant superintendent. Mm-hmm. And I went for it. It was a great time in the district. I saw changes happening in 2015-16 with the board, with the community, stability, and with Dr. Mameen, and a lot of good things were happening, and I wanted to be a part of that. So I took the job as assistant superintendent for the last 5 years. And then last year, a decision had to come about to, you know, what are you going to do next?
Yes, what's next is right.
So really wanting the district to move ahead in the direction that we were moving. And I threw my hat in the ring for a superintendent, and lucky enough, I'm very humbled for this to take on this position. It's a big responsibility, but it's so rewarding.
And much deserved.
Yes.
So
thank you.
Yes,
thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And things are moving along, it appears, publicly, in the direction that has been talked about and planned for several years.
Yeah. So. Two nights ago, we graduated our summer graduation, 193 summer graduates.
That's great.
So when you add it to the 800 that we just graduated in June, that's 993 graduates. That is our largest class ever. So we're very proud of that.
Congratulations to everyone at the district, and certainly to the class of 2022. It's really outstanding.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Very happy.
And of course, I'm sure, along with the whole community and you, wish every graduate the very best to move forward and succeed.
We want to make sure that they come back and tell their stories of how we help them and how we can do better for future graduates, and really have them talk to our current kids and see, you know, what the possibilities are and hear their stories.
It's wonderful. That's a great idea and a plan. I hope that happens.
Yes.
So we could talk about, and we do have a lot of things to talk about, so thank you for sharing that about yourself. I'm sure that people are interested, and they want to know where you've been, what you've done, and you have a wonderful background and experience as an educator. So I'm going to ask you, something that you've achieved in your career that you feel has really made an impact. And I'll speak for you to begin this, okay, if you don't mind. Dr. Murray, because I have personally witnessed this. I mean, she was truly a behind-the-scenes worker, you know, shaker and mover, getting things planned, getting them launched, making sure they happened. I mean, we really did see big, big changes mm-hmm. over a period of about 5 to 7 years mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. that we never thought would happen so quickly. And mm-hmm. and I really do credit you. I personally credit you with a lot of that, making that happen, along with the team and the administration,
yes,
the teachers, this everybody. But I know that you helped with Dr. Mumin to spearhead all of that. So with that said, my knowing that you've done so much, mm-hmm. what's that one thing you might pick out as like your super achievement to make an impact?
So thinking about this question, there were a couple of things. Mm-hmm. One was the performing arts school. Those kids are now 23, 24, 25, and when I see them, they're like, Miss, that was the best Aww. School ever. I miss it, you know, and having that to engage kids so strongly at yes. sixth grade and having them wanting to further their education mm-hmm. because of that, that's huge to me.
That's
some
beautiful.
Other things, the merger of the communities, that was yeah. very difficult but very rewarding. Mm-hmm. But this year, we are starting STEM classes for all elementary kids. Just, you know, other county schools have innovative classes, STEM classes, mm-hmm. and it's needed here.
Yes.
To give kids an up and you know, equal leverage in the science field. So all elementary kids will be having STEM classes.
That's incredible.
Starting the school year, which we're very excited about.
Yes. Yeah. Running Junior Achievement, as I did for many years, we really started to go after STEM mm-hmm. or STEAM classes. Mm-hmm. Do you want to share what STEM represents,
sure.
by the way?
Sure, so it's science, technology, engineering, and math. Sometimes they call it STEAM, so they add the A in for arts mm-hmm. When applicable. It's to me, it's always STEAM because there's always an arts piece into it. Being with a performing arts school for so long, I've been exposed and learned so much about arts and music and theater. And that really adds to that STEM quality.
Yes.
So I say STEAM, or I say STEM, and it's usually, I mean STEAM.
Meaning STEAM.
Yeah. Yeah.
But going back 12, 15 years, and
yeah.
now really seeing the reality of this happening,
yeah.
and the need that exists mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. in the workplace
yes.
For this type of education so that people can be educated and get jobs in fields that there
yes.
aren't enough people for.
Yes.
So
yes.
to see this really transpiring for me is very exciting.
Yes.
And everybody should be excited about that.
Yes, yes. So, and it's more about job skills. So
yes.
it's problem solving, critical thinking, mm-hmm. conflict resolution, collaboration. All of those skills are needed really in every job.
And we talk
that
about
exists.
Those as soft skills, mm-hmm. but there's nothing soft about
yeah.
them. I
yeah.
mean, they're really what we all need to get through and be successful mm-hmm. and achieve in life. So,
yeah.
very excited
yes,
about that.
Exciting.
I'm glad to hear that that's happening
yes.
this fall. Wonderful. Thank you for sharing that with us. Tell us a little bit about, speaking about STEM starting this fall at the level it will be. Where are you with electronics and tools and really bringing the district up to that level and to
sure.
be able to compete with the rest of the districts in
sure.
the county?
So I'll start with our original plan back mm-hmm. in the 1920 school year. We had a 5-year plan to introduce more technology into the Reading School District, and we had a started plan with middle school. And the plan included a one-to-one for high school students at some point. We didn't know. So we started with training, professional development with teachers at the middle school level, more technology, carts, Chromebooks. And in March of 20, everything changed for education as we once knew it. So we shut down, and kids at that time didn't have Chromebooks at home. At that time, on March 13th, we were told 2 weeks we were shutting down. So we came up with activities for kids and to try to keep them engaged at home without technology for 2 weeks. And then during those 2 weeks, we found out it would be longer. And at that point in time, I remember getting word, like, we're not coming back in 2 weeks. And like, well, what are we going to, like, we got to figure out something very quickly. So our five-year plan for technology turned into 3 months plan. We distributed over 18,000 Chromebooks in 3 months to every student in the Reading School District under really strict, if you remember COVID in the beginning, everyone was far away from each other, masked, gloved, and so we had to distribute Chromebooks to families. Then then teach them how to use it,
right?
And then figure out if they had how to connect. How's the wireless at
and
their
have
house?
Something, yeah, to connect
and,
to,
right? Because a Chromebook is not any good with without the Wi-Fi.
Right.
So we put extenders on our schools to reach more houses in the neighborhood for Wi-Fi. We set up hotspots. We handed out hotspots. We engaged in with Comcast to do a low cost internet service to homes. We had social workers and parent outreach people go out to houses to see why students didn't connect yet, where were they, and we remained virtual for a long time. So we always had that connection. But, you know, you talk about what good things came of that. Mm-hmm. You know, kids got a crash course on how to use technology. So our five-year plan really got shrunk, and we're in a better spot today because our little kids know how to use Chromebooks better than ever before. Parents got to see what teachers do through a screen, and where that wasn't happening before. Parents couldn't come into school and watch us all day.
Right.
So this gave them an opportunity to see what we do during the day and see how, you know, kids are taught to read and math skills. Parent conference attendance went way up.
Wow!
Because it made it easy for parents to log on with their teacher using their kid's device. So we had more parent conference attendance, which is something we actually are continuing now that we're back, you know, mask free and
insight.
So we do conferences, we do IP meetings, all virtual. But yeah, the tools it taught us a lot. We had to scramble because again, it was a 5-year plan. We weren't planned to, you know, drop and run, but we did.
Well, and it was never a question, my opinion, of can we do this? It was, we're gonna do it, we gonna do it, right? How are we gonna do it? How quickly can we do it? And I think that some people, I want to remind any home viewers that may have just tuned in, I'm interviewing on Greater Reading Public Eye, Dr. Jennifer Murray, who is the superintendent, fairly new superintendent of the Reading School District. I know that people in our entire county, in our community, realize that the Reading School District is a huge district. But I just want to throw in there, we're so big here that we're the fourth. Are we still the fourth?
Fourth largest.
I know sometimes it goes back
yes.
and forth. But we can say the fourth largest in the Commonwealth, but then that needs to be recognized. There are about or around 500 school districts in the Commonwealth.
Yes.
So it's not just a matter of Philadelphia, Pittsburgh. There's 500 in the entire state. So when you think about four, we are talking very, very big numbers. So it really was.
Yes.
Incredible.
Yes.
And nothing was perfect.
Yes.
We were virtual a long time, but it was about safety and what was best when it came to numbers. So you made it through that.
We did.
And
learned a lot.
Yeah. Yes. And also it was a good lesson in where there's a will, there's a way, as we say in English, right?
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
Make up your mind and figure out how to do it and
make it
happen. So yes, congratulations on that. It was a very interesting time. And I guess the rollout remains interesting as well. As you said, everything changed.
Yes.
Nothing is, as we kept saying as it was happening, nothing's ever going to be exactly the way it once was.
Yes.
And we're experiencing that now. There's been some back and forth controversy, walls drawn, sides created over the Reading Public Museum. Can you share briefly where we're at and the school district's involvement with the museum?
Sure. So the school district has access to the museum through field trips. which are absolutely free. Mm-hmm. And the teachers, we're actually pushing that a lot this year with getting kids. Hopefully all 18,000 will experience it at least once this school year, going to the museum for free with the planetarium. And they actually have access to the museum on non-school days in the summer with their parents for free.
Ah.
So all they show is their Reading School District ID. Mm-hmm. The school district made sure, so we usually don't give IDs to elementary kids, it was just the secondary, but now all kids for the Reading School District has a picture ID, and they would go show their ID, their parents show any kind of form of documentation that they live in the city, a bill, a driver's license, whatever they have to show, the zip code that corresponds with the Reading School District, and they have free access.
So tell us why the Reading School District, because any school district can use the museum, and they do.
Absolutely.
For field trips, and I've seen buses on their campus from other counties as well, which is great, says a lot about the museum. Mm-hmm. And what they have to offer. But why does Reading get to go free and others don't?
So the Reading School District actually owns the museum. Mm-hmm. And the grounds, and it was bequeathed to us from the founder, Dr. Levi Mangle, who was a teacher in the Reading School District, a historian. Mm-hmm. He had collected in his collection various items for the museum and had donated them and had set up and established that museum for children in order to get a hands-on experience to learning. So we are very fortunate to have that resource.
Sure are.
And we are thankful for the managers of the museum. Mm-hmm. Who is the Reading Public the Museum Foundation. Group that does a wonderful job running the museum, and partnered with them and having this wonderful resource, not only for our kids, but for the community.
Absolutely.
So we're very grateful.
Absolutely, we are. And we thank them so much for this opportunity. Mm-hmm. For our not just our children to get in, our students, but to share with their families as well. Mm-hmm. It's a great experience. And I hope that our families take advantage of it.
They have.
Yes, good.
We have, they have been counting, and because
wow.
We've asked for a report.
Yes.
Over 1,500 students and parents
wow.
have accessed that outside of school time.
That is exciting.
Since the spring, yes.
Oh, so good to
yes.
hear.
Yes.
Oh, I love it. We can't get away from this show, walk away from this show, and not talk a little bit about the new building.
Oh, yes, yes.
It's very, also,
very
lots
excited.
Of exciting
yes,
stuff.
Yes, so continuing with the STEM theme, mm-hmm. The Reading School District is building a new building at 9th and Douglas Streets, where the old outlets used to mm-hmm. be. I remember going to them when I moved in the 90s
yes.
up here, going to those outlets. But we will have a new building. And we conducted a series of listening sessions with the community, with the kids, with the staff and the families to talk about what that building could do for our district. What do they want? What kind of building do they want mm-hmm. to serve the kids with? And the possibilities were an elementary school. Another possibility was a kindergarten through eighth grade school, taking enrollment down from like the 12th and Marion, 10th and Green, and Central Middle School, kind of just lowering that enrollment. But the one thing that was very overwhelming that we've heard is the capacity at the high school. They wanted it lowered. It was there's a lot of kids. So we thought, how could we do that and really promote career readiness with the kids in the workplace?
Mm-hmm.
So we ended up doing a STEM high school there, which kids will pick a pathway, and if it's STEM related, we're going to move our pathways down there.
That's
so
great.
We're very excited about that.
That is just going to be a dream come
yes,
true.
Yes.
I hope I get a tour.
You will. You will. The community, everybody will get a tour.
Yeah.
We'll have an open
Wonderful.
House when it's done. Very
You've
excited.
Heard that, home viewers. That's
yes.
great. It's
yeah.
going to really be phenomenal. I can't wait to see it and see that energy and that pickup in
yes.
that part of the city, too,
yes.
again.
Yes.
Because, yes, we do miss those outlets.
Yes.
But
something, it'll be a great resource for
yes.
the kids.
Yeah, definitely. I want to end, if you don't mind, with you having or giving a message to our home viewers about something that you want them to be aware of or you want to share with them.
Sure. So I think I really want everyone to know how much our staff and our administration and really the entire Reading School District works so hard for the community and the kids at Reading. And you may hear bad things, you know, they you know, this happened in the hallway, this, but
it's a big place.
It is a big place. Yeah. It is a big place. And there's lots of schools. Mm-hmm. And sometimes that overshadows all of the good that we do every hour, every day, every week, every month. And I want them to look beyond that and really know and understand how much and how passionate our teachers and our staff members are involved and invested in this district.
See what's
happening. I'm sorry.
I do love the Reading School District, and you're reminding me. I'm sorry. This will be my class coming up in, I guess, 23. It will be 50 years.
Wow.
Reading High. And so you're making me think, and I just said this to someone, I think last week, when I was moving as a child from West Reading, my mother was remarrying. And, of course, I didn't want any of it. I didn't like any of it. I'm going to leave my grandparents. And I was so afraid to go to the Reading School District. You know, it was civil rights. Mm-hmm. There was a lot of turmoil, a lot of things going on. And I was very sheltered in West Reading. And then I did eventually go back and forth to my grandparents all through my education from 6th grade to 12th grade. And they were in West Reading. They said, do you want to come back and go to Y Missing? Nothing against Y Missing, but it was no way. Mm-hmm. I loved Reading so much and loved Reading High and all the friends and the diversity, which I didn't have at that time. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And it was just such an incredible experience. And I made the comment, and I've always made this comment, I feel like Reading High, Reading School District, prepared me for almost anything. Mm-hmm. I really do, and it was a wonderful experience, and I want that for all of our students. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So 50 years, 49 years later, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. 2022, I want those students to experience mm-hmm. that also mm-hmm. moving
Me too.
Forward. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, yes, we truly share that passion. Mm-hmm. So thank you so
You're
much.
You're welcome.
I always love seeing you. And it's always my pleasure to spend some time with you because I know you don't have a lot of it. So, home viewers, I hope you enjoyed Greater Reading Public Eye and Dr. Jennifer Murray from the Reading School District as the superintendent. We certainly wish her the very best of luck. And remember, the museum's over there across the bridge for you to use. We talked about that today. And keep your eyes peeled on that building that's going to be going up there on Douglas, 9th and Douglas Street. So thanks for tuning in and enjoy the rest of the summer, and we'll see you in the fall. Take care and be safe.
Greater Reading Public Eye on BCTV is supported by RCJ Consulting.